If you have seen my channel before, then you might know that I like my headphones wireless. Also important that they can be acquired for a fairly modest budget. So here's what caught my eye. The Superlux 668B. Let's get them out. Voila. Here. It has a lot of cool reviews online talking about its sound quality, especially for its price, usually under $40. I got mine from GearBest on a deal day for 25 euros shipped, so a totally good deal. But I did find a little annoying problem with them. And this is the problem. As it turned out, a wire goes there. Like this. But I do not like wired headphones. So let's get into changing this awkward situation. Roll the intro. What? I don't even have an intro? Who runs this channel? Sheesh. Okay, let's get straight into it then. With no annoying intro. Wait, but I do have a pet. It's called Brady and it can cover my plot hole. Wait, like this. What do we need? First we need a bass. And for the bass we are going to use this double-sided prototype PCB that is tinned on both sides. That is important for a better grip on parts. So if they're just one on side, they can break off more easily. Next up we need, since the thing has 3.5mm headphone, we need a jack to connect to it. Then we need buttons for volume up, volume down, and for pairing. Also, it needs to be turned on and off, so an on and off button would be good. Now, the main part for communicating the audio wirelessly. Let's use this thing. What is this thing, you might ask? And I am glad you asked, because this is something that uses a high quality protocol called APT-X. That is like the best audio you can get over Bluetooth for right now. So this is what we are using. And the module name is something like CSR8645 on eBay, and you can get this for around $10. Now, what else does our module need? It needs a battery. Let's use this one. This is from one of my quadcopters, mini quadcopters. 380 milliamp hours. I'll be testing for how long this lasts on those big headphones. Now, you don't want to be taking the battery off every time it needs charging, so we need to have a charger on board too. This charger is just TP something 4056. This is also like under a dollar apart. Now, and it communicates to Bluetooth dongle that doesn't cost anything either. Bluetooth 4 dongles go for a dollar or something. So let us start by checking the initial layout. First things to go on would be buttons. Headphone check. Power button. The battery. This would be the initial layout, battery charger, how about we put this on the other side so it can be charged from behind. Sounds good. Yeah, and this will face, this is the antenna here, this will face computer. Now I have marked here a place for cutout. This is not exactly required, it will work without this cutting, but it will give a wider reach for the antenna. These things might interfere with it because it's metal on both sides. So let's cut this out. For that we are going to use a trusty Dremel tool that has no power, so it doesn't work. Let me fix that. Okay, it got fixed. Don't need this. So, the Dremel tool. Sorry for the noise. Part of the business. Now, this should. Come off rather easily. And not give us much trouble. Good.
Anyway, now, let's just make those parts stick to where they should be and then figure out the wiring. So, we'll try a little solder here, and let's just use one thing for right now. I think it seems from going off. Buttons. Is this the right way? They all have one common. They all run from the common to the. So yeah, the buttons are this side.
So since old me was, old me was explaining it rather poorly, then let me chime in from the future here and make it clearer a little bit faster. Those three buttons must do three functions: volume up, volume down, and common, also known as play and pause. There are three pins here: volume up, volume down, and play pause. This is what they must be connecting to do their function. So if I press the play button, press the volume up, then volume up must be connected to, and not ground, but the common. There is com written on here. So all three buttons must have one side of them going to the common and the other side to their function. So I turn those buttons to face this way, that these pins connect to the bottom pins. So all top pins connect to common, and now from bottom each one has one going to play button, volume down button, volume up button. So that's it, and let's let our younger self continue. Okay, now this will be the charging board, and I should try fitting it here. Maybe not doing that. There you go, charging port fitted. Oh, and I changed this resistor beforehand because this is from this resistor the charging board will decide how fast it is charging the battery. So you need to have a proper resistor here not to charge it too fast. So that's how the setup would look like. Show you how it goes on to the
show you how it should be connected to this.
There. Not too bad, I think, but we need some kind of case for it. And we need to do all the wiring job now for the connections. So let's get into that now. Now a little explanation what I just did. This module has both microphone and headphones pins. So these top three are audio left, out, audio ground and audio right channel out on this left and right side of the headphones. So I connected the audio right to the right channel, audio left to the left channel, and audio ground to the ground channel inside this. When you are connecting, you should just figure out what's the correct pins to solder on. So that is done. Also, if you do want, this is able to take microphone. There are microphone pins too. So let's continue on, and we are going to connect power next. Now let's explain what happened in the meantime. I connected the charger to the battery leads. I made the battery leads out of this bended I don't remember what it was called, pin headers, 90 degrees, and so that I don't have to break the connector, because I don't have the socket that's required for this. If you can get one, then you can make it look prettier than I did. Oh, and I right now realized that I didn't connect my power button. So I do have to now disconnect this and make it go through the switch here so that we could turn it on and off. But then the wiring is complete, I think. Now I can show you that the charger is already working. It's showing red, that means it's charging. So now I only have to wire this power button so it will do something, and then the wiring is pretty much done, and we can, I think, I still have the buttons to wire. Ooh. Not so fast, Timmy. Eh? Okay. Let us test if the... No, I can't yet. Okay, buttons. Now, buttons are also connected, soldered, so we can, oops, it's off, okay. So we can now test, does it work? First, let's turn it on. As you can see from the indicator, this module was previously connected to my mobile phone, so pressing the play button paused my video recording. Now let's see, can my computer see it? Yes, it can. Pair it up. Now it is pairing. While it is doing that, let's make some room on this messy table.
Oh, it's testing. Have to clean up those pins. That's what it is. But it is connected, Windows is still doing its thing. Like, installing. So.
Here are the headphones. Please connect to the module like that. And whoop. There you go. Now let us see if we can get some beat. Okay, let's try disconnecting it. Reconnect. Oh, did you hear it? No. There was some sound. The connection sound, I think. No. He will go to the disco. It is like being in a party for him. I believe you can hear that. This is, oh sorry. So it's working. What is next, you might ask? Well, this looks ugly. We must make some kind of cover to it. For it. So here is the final design with the cover printed. I had to make few little adjustments. I had to move those openings few millimeters here and there. And also, let me show you. I changed the facing of the charging port. It was facing this way to the rear, but now I change it to face down. So if you are sitting and the battery gets low and you don't want to stop listening, then you can just have a little battery back in your pocket and charge it up while still using it and walking around in your living room or house. And if you want to use something like this for generic use with any headphones, then just turn this headphone jack around, make it face outwards here, and if anyone wants to replicate the same design, I can share those design files. Just let me know in the comments and I can make it one that has a hole down here too, not just up there. So, but you must make some rear cover yourself. I don't plan to make one right now because it's fine enough as it is for me right now. So that is it, and thank you for watching. I hope this was interesting, and leave me a like if you liked it so YouTube knows to show this to other people that are interested in wireless headphones. And come back when I have another video. This is me and Brady saying goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.